The global dietary supplement market is a multi-billion dollar industry, and it is expected to grow every year. Why? Because more and more people are interested in their personal health. In the US, 62 million people suffer from arthritis. Because our joints contain a protein called collagen, the supplement market containing this protein has exploded. The question is, do collagen supplements really help patients suffering from joint pain or arthritis? This is a very frequent question that I get from my patients. This is why today I'm starting a mini series of lectures that will address the most common supplements that are used by patients with arthritis or joint pain. I will discuss the scientific evidence that we have about collagen, glucosamine, chondroitin, fish oil, turmeric, and vitamin D. In this video, I will discuss the following questions. What is collagen? And what are the collagen supplements? And what are supplements in general? Are collagen supplements good for arthritis? And very important, can you get collagen from foods?
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
Hi, I'm Dr. Girnita, the founder of Rheumatologist OnCall. In my YouTube channel, I educate people about arthritis, autoimmune diseases, and the best methods that you can use to live better with arthritis. If you're new here, welcome. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you have been following this channel for a while, I'm excited to have you back and share more information with you. First, what is collagen? Collagen is the most abundant protein in our body. It is found in your bones, skin, muscles, tendons, and cartilage. Collagen makes your tissue strong and allows us to stretch. As we age, our body will slow down the production of collagen, and the networks of collagen into our skin changes from a tightly organized network to an unorganized maze. So how can we change this? Well, that's where the idea of supplements came in. What are supplements? Supplements are natural and/or synthetic products marketed to supplement your diet for optimal health results. They can include vitamins, minerals, herbs, amino acids, enzymes, extracts, or concentrates. However, because dietary supplements are characterized as foods and not drugs, they are not required to go a very rigorous testing like other medication. Dietary supplement manufacturers are responsible to ensure that these are safe before they are marketed, but they do not require to be approved by the Food and Drug Administration. The manufacturers may not claim to treat, prevent, or cure any specific disease. What about collagen supplements? Collagen supplements became a top-selling product. They started out as supplements for stronger skin and nails, and more recently, collagen supplements were advertised for stronger bones and improvement in the cartilage. A common form of collagen supplementation are oral collagens. They are sold as collagen peptides or hydrolyzed collagen, which are broken down forms of collagen that are more easily absorbed. Now for the real question, are collagen supplements good for arthritis? To answer this question, I think it is very important to understand the scientific data available today. Collagen supplements were studied primarily in people suffering with osteoarthritis. Osteoarthritis is a form of wear and tear arthritis that usually happens in elderly people. It is a form of degenerative arthritis that can affect your hands, hips, knees, and spine, and more rarely can affect other joints. Patients with osteoarthritis will have pain and difficulties using their hands or walking, depending on the type of joint that is affected. If you want to learn more about different types of arthritis, make sure you watch the other videos in my channel. Now, there have been several studies performed, but I will dive into a few that I consider significant. A study published in 2006 showed that patients with osteoarthritis that use collagen hydroxylate had improvement in their pain scores and function of their joints. In 2018, a meta-analysis of nutritional supplements for osteoarthritis of the knees, hands, and hip, which included 69 studies, looked at 20 different supplements. In their analysis, they included studies on turmeric, glucosamine, chondroitin, but also on collagen supplements. In the study, 20 supplements and placebo replacements were used. Remember that placebo treatments are involved in trials to make sure that the medication actually works. A placebo treatment has no real effect other than the mental state, which we do test whether the results are due to the treatment versus to simply the belief of the subject. Now, returning to the results of this study, interestingly, when they compared them to placebo, only 7 out of the 20 supplements, including collagen hydroxylate, showed to have an impact in reducing the pain in the patients with osteoarthritis. In addition, the reduction in pain was short-term, just under 3 months. In 2019, another meta-analysis on collagen supplementation was published. Again, collagen supplementation was shown to improve the symptoms of osteoarthritis. However, most of the studies have a limited number of patients, and the quality of the evidence is considered to be moderate to very low. Based on these studies, it is important to note that these supplements did not cause significantly higher side effects when they were compared to placebo. Be aware that some of these studies are supported by the manufacturer that produces these supplements, so there might be limitations involved, including a conflict of interest and other biases. So, are collagen supplements the only hope? How about getting collagen from foods? In fact, collagen is present in many foods. Here are just a few foods abundant in collagen: pot roast, brisket, bones and skin of saltwater fish, bone growth, and gelatin. However, most of the foods containing collagen will be digested by our stomach and converted into amino acids, which are the building blocks for proteins. Those will get distributed through our body and used to build more proteins. So, as of now, we don't know if eating more collagen will influence the amount of collagen in our body and in turn will influence our joint disease. To summarize, collagen supplements might be helpful for patients with arthritis, although the current evidence is still moderate to low. Before you take any supplement, I do advise you to discuss your clinical situation with a physician that will be able to review the risk and the benefits. Know that supplements can be dangerous in some situations and can also influence the way that other medications are absorbed. Remember, this is just an educational lecture and will not provide you with medical advice. If you like the educational content of these videos, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. In the next lecture, I will discuss about glucosamine and chondroitin that are also supplements used very frequently by patients with joint pain or arthritis. Have a great day and see you very soon.
Rheumatologist OnCall.com